welcome to my channel. I'm Jennifer of Custom Chic, and if you're new here, let me be the first to welcome you. My channel focuses on fashion, travel, and just overall lifestyle, and you can catch me on Instagram at customs_chic. Now, if this is the kind of content that you are into, then let me challenge you to like, to share, to subscribe, and to hit the bell notification so you know each time I drop a video. I upload every Wednesday and every Friday, and welcome to this week's edition of Flash Fashion Friday. What are we doing today? You are packing with me because we are going on another trip. I know. We just went to Houston, which when we went was supposedly a hotbed, but we took some extra measures and I felt safe about the trip. I felt really good about the flying process. So now I'm kicking up the ante. I am flying internationally. Drum roll, please. I can never find that sound effect in iMovie. That was the drum roll that I'm gonna give y'all. So I am actually going to Cancun for a post-dated bachelorette party. We were supposed to have this bachelorette party back in the beginning of March, but obviously we know what has happened since then, COVID. So now that countries are opening back up a little bit, and obviously you want to celebrate my friend, we are headed to Cancun for a 4-day, 3-night extravaganza. And I'm bringing you guys along with me. So let's go ahead and pack. For my outfit, I am wearing something super simple. I am wearing a Beatles shirt and a pair of ripped up wide leg denim jeans from none other than Graffiti Garb. I will link everything down in the description box. If you want to see this entire look, you know what to do. You know what to do. Follow me on Instagram at customs_chic. Let's get to packing, y'all. I got some goodies that I'm super excited to wear. Now that I'm finally going somewhere, I feel like it's time to up the ante a little bit again. Okay, so let's get packing. This is obviously gonna be super quick. I'm just gonna show you guys what I'm wearing. I'm gonna throw it into the suitcase. You've seen my pack with me videos before. If you haven't, I will tag those up there, but it is the same phenomenon, same method to my madness. Again, 4 days, 3 nights, so I'm packing super light. Everything will come with me in a carry-on. And what I wanna talk about first is my first daytime outfits. I have 3 of those. So first, I am going to be wearing an oldie but goodie, old pair of distressed black denim jeans from Paige. These are a size 30, and the name of this short is called Margot. I bought these from Bloomingdale's a while ago, like when we could be outside and then some, like that's how long. And then a couple years at that. I'm just wearing these. These are super comfortable. Again, I've had them for a long time, so they have kind of taken to my body. I know what I can eat, what I can't eat. I know my comfort level in these shorts, so I always bring these. And again, you always want to travel with a black pair of shorts. Now, they're a little washed out. Some might say ashy. So I may dye these when I come back, but for today's purposes, they are just fine. And I am pairing it with this super cute t-shirt that I purchased from Ross. This t-shirt was $5.99, and it just says queen in different variations, because you know melanin is a poppin'. Yes, it is. So this is a size large. If you come across a Ross and you're interested in this shirt and it has the kind of African print or dashiki print that most people, you have seen this print in some way, shape, or form in your lifetime. If you haven't, where you been? So that is the first daytime outfit that I will be bringing along on this trip. I'm excited for this. It's cute and it's easy. I don't think that we will be venturing off. At least I will not be venturing off the resort very often, just because it's all inclusive. So everything you really need is there. I know that resorts have deals with a lot of travel agencies where they offer like excursions and stuff like that. I don't know that we will be partaking in any of those, and I also don't know if those are being offered right now. So, you know, something very easy if we just kind of want to walk around and talk to some street vendors and pick up some stuff outside of the resort, maybe, but I don't foresee us doing a lot of, you know, travel off the property. Second daytime outfit is these pair of shorts. These are my Ribcage camo Levi's denim. You guys have seen these before. I did a pack with me video when I went to Houston for Juneteenth a couple weeks ago. So these are still the same. When I did the video, I don't think I had already gotten them tailored. I did mention to you guys that I would. So this is the end product. I brought them to my tailor. I originally purchased these from TJ Maxx, and they were a size 31. Right now I'm running at a 28, 29, so I just needed a couple of little stitching right here just to make these fit. Wide leg on the bottom, very roomy, very comfortable. I planned to wear these with just a regular white crop top t-shirt that I purchased from Zara. This is $12.99. I didn't purchase all of these things, if they have a tag on them, in anticipation of this trip. I have purchased them just kind of throughout quarantine and just have not had the opportunity to get them. This was not part of the Zara haul that I did earlier on in the week. If you missed that, let me pop that up here so that you can see it. You definitely don't want to miss that. I have some good goodies, good tips, but I have some good and some bad with the recent summer end sale from Zara. So very quickly, I will probably wear these with sneakers, if not just regular sandals. And day outfit number three, this is a pair of blue shorts, a darker wash from the camo ones from 7 for All Mankind. These are also in a size 30. Oldies but goodies. Like I said, I'm running at a 28, 29 right now, but because I've had these for so long, they actually kind of just form fit to my body. And I love denim. Probably my favorite brand of denim is 7 for All Mankind, just because they're for all mankind. I'm just kidding. I totally made that up right now. Just like right now. And then I'm going to wear it with like a ruffled off the sleeve shirt that I picked up from Ross a couple of days ago. It's actually a leotard and it has, or a bodysuit, whichever way you prefer to refer to them as, same function. There's a clasp at the end. I got these in a size large just because I wanted something to be a little bit more roomy. And yeah, those are my daytime looks. I mean, they're not like super pizzazz, it's super casual, super simple, and we're gonna get a little bit more, you know, haute couture for dinner. And here are the daytime outfits in the actual suitcase. I try to separate my denim out as much as possible so that there is an even balance. If you put all your denim together, because they are the weightiest of fabrics, they will kind of, what's that, weigh it down. So I try to always keep them separate, and then I put on lighter fabrics in between so that everything fits in there perfectly. Okay, next up I want to talk about the dinner looks. I packed three dinner outfits. I'm not sure again if we're gonna go off site. I never know with my friends, so rather be safe than sorry. My first one is this co-ord set that I bought from House of Belle. I have actually featured this outfit before, and the entire look is on my Instagram. Again, customs_chic. This is just a, hold on, let me put those down so I can talk about this a little bit more. This is a long sleeve poplin button down shirt. It has a really great detailing here where I can zip it up or down instead of like that super annoying buttoning that happens sometimes. The poplin itself does not zip up or down. You do have to go down and close the buttons. But I mean, I think that's better because it gives you a better opportunity to decide how open or how closed or how exposed or covered you would like the girls to be. So I'm gonna wear this one night. And then again, it comes with a matching pair of shorts. This is actually the front. There is a pocket detail, and then it has a matching belt. The belt is actually bigger than I am, so I more than likely will switch this out for another belt that I have in my closet. But this is actually dinner outfit number one. So I'm just gonna place this in the suitcase. And I just showed you guys how I tend to separate my denim again so that they all don't bunch up in one area of the suitcase and weigh it down. I'm just trying to find some equilibrium so that when I'm pulling this thing through the airport, I'm not super annoyed that I overpacked, which I didn't. But if I did, at least my clothes will balance out in the suitcase. So, outfit number two. This shirt is my Jungle Book shirt. I actually refer to it as that. I did pick this up recently from Zara. Again, if you missed it, this was part of my summertime Zara haul from the summer end sale that they were having. It's in a size large. I haven't worn it yet. It's actually in size, large. It's $39.90. When I purchased it, it was $39.90. I don't know the current price of it right now, but I will be more than happy to put that in the description box if you guys are interested. And I am wearing them, this is one of the looks that is gonna have a proper heel, with my new Manolo Blahnik sandals. These sandals are so cute and they're so comfortable. While on Instagram, I actually asked you guys to participate. These were on sale and I was loving them. And I was like, guys, should I buy them? And most people responded that I should. So they came in a couple of weeks ago. I actually have a picture and I'll pop it up wearing these shoes. So comfortable. Such a beautiful shoe. The leather is soft, it's nice and supple. Even though these straps are a little bit thicker, they do not dig into my skin. I mean, just this braided detail right here. You know what, you guys deserve that. I will pop up a picture of me actually wearing this shoe so that you can just see all of its beauty. Now, the bottom parts of this outfit, so my Jungle Book shirt and these Manolos, I'm not sure yet. I am deciding between a pair of jeans and a pair of fuchsia spandex. I know, very Peg Bundy, but it'll be a look, whichever one I decide. Dinner outfit number three is probably the one that I am most excited about. It is this two-piece corset top. Let me put the skirt down, from Pretty Little Things. Look at this, mama. I mean, just gorgeous. So this is the corset top and it has an exposed zipper in the back with the, let me move all of the stuff out of the way, sorry guys. Okay, so this is the corset top with the exposed zipper in the back with the orange lining there. This bustier is actually super cute. I purchased this in a size 10. I ordered a size 8 and 10 just because I wasn't sure how the girls were gonna react. The 8 was not giving us any life, so I needed to get the 10. And there's some piping in there for the bustier kind of. It's not very, very sturdy, but then once it's zipped up, I feel super like sucked in and supported. So just beware, it's not your typical like, I don't know, 1920s ribcage bustier. It will keep you in, but it's not super, super cinched in. And then it comes with this beautiful ruched draping of a dress. I mean, no, I'm sorry, this is a skirt. I haven't removed this yet because this just came in and I wanted to make sure that the sizing was right. So I purchased a top in a 10 and an 8, and then I purchased a skirt in a 6 and an 8 just because I wanted to be sure that the two pieces will work together, and I wasn't exactly sure on sizing for Pretty Little Things, but it worked out. Skirt in the size 6. Look at these layers, like this is gonna move so beautifully on the body. I'm gonna put up a picture with the model in it so that you guys can see the entire look together. And then again, make sure, I mean, stay tuned to the Insta because it's gonna drop. Also, stay tuned for the vlog from next week because I'm sure I'm gonna vlog this entire trip. So I'll try to do like a get ready with me portion of it so that you guys can see how this like moves, maybe in the bedroom and then at like nighttime when we go out to dinner. So those are the three dinner time looks. Okay, I have now added the dinner time looks. I separated these two only because this top, like I said, is a bustier and it has just a little bit of boning. So I wanted to make sure it laid completely flat. And then I just put the skirt there. And this is the outfit from House of Belle. This is my little Jungle Book shirt. And then I'm gonna throw my shoes in there, in their regular shoe bag in between clothing so it doesn't take up too much room. And then now all we have to do is bathing suits and pajamas and then we're good. Okay guys, so I did actually decide to add some other accessories. If you can see right here, this is my straw wide brim hat from ASOS. I'm gonna take this along with me because I think it'll work in some areas where there's no shading or if I can use it for a photo op because everybody loves a good photo op. Especially me. So I'm gonna take this with me. I'm also gonna pack it in my carry-on, but I will show you guys how I do that once I get all of the bathing suits together. So my first bathing suit look is going to be my always favorite, never home but always reppin' FAMU bathing suit. I purchased this from my good girlfriend shop, Graffiti Garb. I don't know if they still have it, but if they do, I will definitely put that information in the description box. And I'm going to pair it this time with a different cover-up from Forever 21. I actually purchased this sheer beaded just overall of a dress. I don't even remember when, as I was trying to pull things for this trip, I found it and I thought, oh, the white beading will play really well off of the white on the FAMU bathing suit, so why not bring it? The last time I wore this FAMU bathing suit, I went extra with the cover up from a top, actually it was a dress from A Tribe of Kin, I believe is who I got it from, and I'll pop up a picture. And I wore that in Ghana, but I just thought it would be fun to just play with a little bit of dainty and a lot of skin, because this bathing suit is high rise, and you know, you know what I'm saying. I'm not gonna model this, I don't model bathing suits, so you can catch a picture on Instagram though. The bathing suit that I'm going to be packing and bringing with me to Cancun is this super cute, colorful diagonal bathing suit that just says Aloha. I purchased this from Nordstrom's Rack probably last year. I've never worn it, it still has a tag on it, and it was $8.99. I got it on clearance, like, can you deal? Like, $8.99, can't go wrong. It has an open back and doesn't have that much support in the front, but I got this in a size, I want to say this is a size small. Actually, it's a medium, so it'll fit. A medium will fit. And I am going to pair this with another cover-up, same kind of beaded sheer look. I purchased these pants from Amazon. This was part of another set, not with that shirt that I just showed you guys from Forever 21, but the same kind of concept. I originally wore these with an oversized white t-shirt for the Florida A&M versus Bethune-Cookman College Classic last year. So that was a good look, but then I saw these and I was like, oh, this might work as well for a cover-up. I don't have any pant cover-ups and I wanted to try that look, so we'll see if this works. So if you see a picture of this, then you know that it did in fact work, and if it didn't, then you know that it didn't work. Because bathing suits are lighter, I'm just gonna throw these on top and then kind of just pack my hat around all of that. So you guys will see that in just a second, I will show you. And then for my third bathing suit look, this is just a teal number from ASOS. These come in a variety of different colors. I actually have this in a yellow as well. I've seen it in white, I've seen it in red, I've seen it in blue. This is a very standard bathing suit that ASOS comes out with every single season. It was very inexpensive. That's not true, because sometimes ASOS can get expensive, but this one in particular was very inexpensive. This is a size medium. If I can still find this, then I would put it in the description box. If I cannot, then I will find something similar that I can put and give you guys information to. The cover up for this one is my favorite oldie but goodie from Forever 21. This sort of leaf white and green caftan. I take this on all of my trips. It never fails me. I can usually wear this as a dress. Even if I'm leaving the beach or the pool, I can just throw on some shorts and then have this on, and it's nice and flowy, this billowy material, and it always works. So I'm bringing this along with me as the cover up for the ASOS bathing suit. And then again, I'm just throwing these in here because they're super lightweight. And I mean, this suitcase is, it's very light, which that is the way we want to keep it. Let me show you guys how I pack my hat, and then I'll come back and we'll do a quick little outro. So that is how I pack my hat. Super easy, not overly complicated. You just throw it in there, you stuff it on each side to make sure that it's kind of like cupping whatever clothes are underneath it, and then you stick your lighter items right on top. I did actually put the sports bra within the brim of the hat, so that way it had a little bit more structure and I keep it a little bit more safe. Obviously there's some like underwire within the sports bra, so I felt a little bit more comfortable in keeping it there. If you don't have anything with underwire or anything like that, you can put whatever you want within the brim of the hat. Just make sure that it's going to keep its shape. Before we go, I also did just pack a throwaway dress, or a throw-on dress, I should say. This is just a regular black knit dress that I purchased from, I want to say, Pretty Little Things. I'm almost positive I also packed this to go to Houston last time we were together, packing together. And I didn't even throw this one on. I ended up wearing another house dress. So I like having these around just because you can put this on while you're doing your makeup. You don't necessarily want to be in your pajamas after you've taken a shower, because that's for the bed and you don't want to do that. And I'm also packing an additional outfit for just in case. You guys want to see that one? I know you do. Okay, so what am I bringing? I am bringing just one extra dinner outfit in case the ones that I have packed do not work out. in case I change my mind. I just need options, right? I may get there and be like, this does not even work. This look does not work. So I'm bringing my new favorite sleeper kind of pajama style set from Zara. If you guys want to know, I'm gonna leave the description of all of this in the description box, or leave the details rather in the description box. It was also part of my Zara haul video that I did earlier on in the week. If you haven't caught that, in the description box, also part of what is it part of? Oh, I put it in the card somewhere. So that is all that I have. Make sure that you guys come back next week, because I will be vlogging this entire Cancun trip and just kind of spend the weekend with me for the next 3 to 4 days. I'm already in Cancun by the time you're watching this. I have been here already, or been there already, for a couple of days. So thank you so much for watching. If you stuck around this long, you already know what to do. Make sure you like, you subscribe, you hit the bell notification so you know each time I drop a video, which is every Wednesday and every Friday. And make sure you share this with a friend, because I'm almost positive people are gonna wanna know what the travel experience is like internationally during COVID. Last vlog I did, it was travel during COVID nationally, and this time it will be internationally. And I'll probably drop some tidbits on Instagram just to kind of keep you guys guessing and to make sure that I'm safe along the way. So I love y'all. I appreciate y'all for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.